our service on this day of Pentecost, where our congregation is flooded with red, the color of the Holy Spirit. And we have a very lively service planned this morning, very full. So just want to make sure that everyone got everything they might need during the service. A bulletin, an insert with the liturgy for communion, an insert with the lyrics to Peace Train by Cat Stevens, an instrument of your choosing, a boarding pass so you can get on the train for free, and then your elements for communion. Anyone need anything?
If you don't have the boarding pass, you have to pay.
And Stephanie is the collector, and I hear she can be kind of tough. Are there any announcements this morning? And I invite you to stand for our call to worship.
God declares, I will pour out my spirit upon all flesh. Your sons and daughters shall prophesy.
The young shall see visions. The elders shall dream dreams.
Both men and women shall prophesy.
And everyone who calls on the name of the Lord shall be saved.
Holy Spirit,
come again. Come as breath, as wind, as fire, to enlighten us as a people and a community of faith. Pour out your spirit upon us as we sing our praises to you, as we celebrate the gift of the church, as we seek to follow in the ways of Jesus, and to commit ourselves to justice and world peace. Open us to new directions, to the visions of the young, and to the dreams of the elders. Come, Holy Spirit, come again. Amen.
And I believe it could be someday it's going to come, because out on the edge of darkness there rides a peace train. Oh, peace train, take this country, come take me home again. Now, I've been smiling lately, thinking about the good things to come, and I believe it could be something good has begun. Oh, peace train, sounding louder. Glide on the peace train. Come on, the peace train. Peace train, holy roller, everyone jump up on the peace train. Get your bags together, go bring your good friends too, because it's getting nearer, it soon will be with you. Now come on and join the living. It's not so far from you, and it's getting nearer. Soon it will all be true. Oh, peace train sounding louder. Ride on the peace train. Come on, the peace train. Why can't we live in bliss? Now I've been crying lately, thinking about the world as it is. Why must we go on hating? Why can't we live in bliss? Because out on the edge of darkness, there rides a peace train. Oh, peace train, take this country. Come take me home again.
Thank you. So a few brief instructions before our invitation to board the peace train. Don't forget your tickets, Mr. Stephanie will charge you. So many of you were here on Palm Sunday, and you will remember that we started the procession, and we will go all the way around, this time because of communion. Instead of coming across the steps here, we're going to go out through the vestibule. My allergies have warped me. The vestibule. Oh, gracious spirit, come now. Take me away. And then we'll keep going around as Matt and the choir are singing. You also have the words in your insert if you would like to join in the singing, or if you'd rather just make your instruments add to the joyous sound. Stephanie will be leading the peace train processions with her peace kite. Come, children of God, and board the peace train. Praise God with instruments and singing. Celebrate the gift of the Holy Spirit and the birth of the church. Listen for the sound of the whistle and the conductor's call. Woo!
Thinking about Why must we go on hating? Why can't we live this? Cause out on the edge of darkness, there rides a peace train. Peace train, take this country. Come take this one again. Peace train sounding louder. Ride on the peace train. Peace train, a holy roller. Everyone on the peace train. Ooh, 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 ooh. Come on, peace train. Climb on the peace train. Hop on the peace train. This is a peace train.
Their heads were on fire?
Well, not exactly, sort of. here, and then...
There's more?
Yes, listen. Then all of Jesus' friends started talking in other languages.
Like this?
Just like that. People in the streets heard them and hurried to the house. They were amazed.
Pontus, Asia, and Phrygia.
Pamphylia, Egypt.
Crete, Arabia.
Libya.
And I'm from San Diego.
I'm really from Charleston.
And we are from down the street. Are we in the right place? Is this Paxton? So much excitement. Noise.
It was an amazing scene. But some onlookers make fun of the apostles. But Peter, who was the leader of the group, stood up and said,
No, we're completely sober and fine. It's 9 in the morning, for goodness sake. No, you're seeing is what God promised you, the prophet Joel, a long time ago.
The old shall dream dreams, and everyone who calls on the name of God will be saved.
And that's the story of Pentecost, the end.
Hold on.
Wait a second.
We want to know what happened next.
Did the friends of Jesus stop being afraid?
Well, you're all friends of Jesus, aren't you?
Yes, we are.
Well, then that's a question you have to answer for yourselves.
A question we have to answer?
Well, we're going to need some help with that.
Then maybe we should pray.
Yes, we should. Come, Holy Spirit, come. Come, Holy Spirit, come. Come, Holy Spirit, come. Come, Holy Spirit, come.
I do not give to you as the world gives. Do not let your hearts be troubled, and neither let them be afraid. Come, Holy Spirit, come. Illuminate the scripture to us this morning, that we may deepen our faith and rejoice in your love for us and for all people. Amen. Our reading from Acts of the outpouring of God's Holy Spirit was brought alive to us by our Paxton players, choir, and musicians, including the sound effects, the whoosh of the Holy Spirit, the rumbling as the home was shaking from the force of the wind. And there were some images somewhere in that music about tongues of fire. Well done. It has been 7 weeks now since the death and resurrection of Jesus. And the early followers were gathered in the home for worship, which was their practice at that time. It was while they were in the home that they were filled with the Holy Spirit and began to speak in other languages. And the Spirit gave them ability, which was expertly demonstrated by our choir this morning, speaking in, how many languages do you?
10
languages. That's powerful. And the outpouring of the Spirit marks the birth of the Christian church. It's striking to me that the early followers of Jesus gathered in a home to worship together. It's a practice that became familiar to some of us during the pandemic. Unable to gather in our church buildings, in our sanctuaries, we had to learn creative ways to worship, to pray, creative ways to receive communion. Some of us did that on Zoom or Facebook. I learned that it is possible, the breaking of the bread and the pouring of the cup and even the pouring of baptismal water, all via Zoom. The Southern New England Conference of the UCC, of which we are a member church, adapted, innovated, and reimagined worship in new ways, including an ordination service conducted by Zoom. And 2 weeks ago, as we celebrated confirmation and we prayed for the Spirit to be poured out upon the confirmants, it is the laying on of hands, which is also a critical part of ordination services. But somehow they found ways to do that even via Zoom. There was a learning curve for most of us. And my understanding is that here at Paxton, there were some care packages that went home to children and youth. And before coming here, your website informed me that during the pandemic, you had ashes to go, that you could come to the church and pick up your ashes and a tattoo, which I presume was of ashes or the cross, and be able to observe that sacred day at home. You've heard me say this before, but it's always striking to me that it is Peter, the disciple who denied Jesus, who now plays such a pivotal role in the birth of the Christian church. It is Peter who preaches to the crowd gathered around the disciples. Peter draws upon the wisdom of the prophet Joel and his vision that in the last days, God's Spirit will be poured out upon all flesh. Your sons and your daughters shall prophesy. The young shall see visions. The elders shall dream dreams. Peter proclaims to the church then and to us today that God's Spirit is poured out upon all people, upon all flesh. It is a vision of inclusion of all humankind in God's work in the world. No one is excluded from the widening circle of being blessed by the Spirit. In other words, all are welcome here. All are welcome into the community of followers of Jesus. All have gifts, each and every one of you, bestowed upon you by the Holy Spirit to strengthen the church and the body of Christ. And all are welcome at the table to a feast of God's love and grace in the breaking of bread, in the pourings of the cup. Last Sunday, we observed the ascension of the Lord. As is written in Luke's Gospel, that while Jesus was blessing them, he withdrew from them and was carried up into heaven. The sermon reflected on themes of transitions, blessings, and the art of departure. Themes which seemed especially fitting for your congregation as a congregation in transition. The congregation then had an opportunity to participate in the sermon and to reflect, on two questions. The first question, what blessing or blessings do you need as a congregation in this time of transition? And the second question, what blessings do you want to offer to the children and the youth in your church family? Your responses were inspirational to me. Your responses were abundant, so much so that our service lasted more than an hour. Because the Holy Spirit was speaking here. So this morning, on this day of Pentecost, it seems an especially fitting time. Sorry, my allergies. To share your responses with the congregation. Blessings in response to the question, what blessing you need as a congregation at this time of transition include blessings to find a new pastor, confidence in our ability to discern whom we need as our new pastor, to remember that God can transform disappointment into a blessing. A blessing to grow and prosper so we can do good things for our community. Contentment about blessings we already have here. The return of active members of the church. For differences of opinion to be respected. The blessings you spoke about for the children and youth included. The blessing of stability and safety. A place to show up and to know that they are loved beyond your own immediate families. That our children and youth would recognize the gifts they have been given by God's Spirit. A blessing of the beauty of art and diversity of expression and the blessing of a moral compass. There are two additional questions for reflection that we never got to last Sunday. Today, I'm just going to share them with you.
I'm so sorry.
So that you can reflect on them during the summer season. So the first one is, what blessings do you as a congregation want to offer the community of Paxton and others beyond the walls of your church? What expectations or traditions may you need to let go of or relinquish to make space for new blessings and new ways of being church in this time and place? Friends, like the early followers of Jesus, gathered with one another on that first Pentecost, we too, in all of our congregations, are wrestling what it means to be the church as we emerge out of the pandemic. And Pentecost is a time of visioning, reimagining, dreaming, creating, trusting, and daring to take risks as we move together into the future. And as you move into the future, do so with confidence and remember always that God declares this: I pour out my spirit upon all flesh. Your sons and your daughters shall prophesy. The young shall see visions. The elders shall dream dreams. Beloved in Christ, rejoice, for God's Holy Spirit has been poured out on the First Congregational Church of Paxton for 274 years, and God's Spirit is leading this congregation into the future with hope. Thanks be to God for this gift of the Spirit, and may the people say, Amen.
Amen.
As we enter into prayer this morning, are there joys or concerns to share with one another? Yes.
School ends.
Kyla, I don't quite hear you.
School ends next week.
All right. So, praise God. School ends next week. And Kyla, what grade can you go into in the fall?
10.
Alright, congratulations. For those of you who were not here 2 weeks ago, Kyle was also one of our new confidants. So we are very joyous about that. Other concerns, yeah.
Safe travels for Desiree Kent.
Yes. Struck my heart Henry Hart for catching this week. In learning that just since the shooting in Uvalde, there have been 20 other mass shootings in our country in that short span of time. And so we need to pray for peace and work for justice and work for solutions. What else? Yes, Dave.
People of Ukraine.
The people of Ukraine. Even as you know, our lives move forward, they are still hurting and struggling. Very much.
The children of Ukraine.
And for the children of Ukraine.
Many of them have been abused. So, it's quite dire.
Absolutely.
Thank you.
What else, Sis Marie? Yes.
Economic stability with the increasing inflation.
So economic stability with the increasing inflation that is making basic needs hard to be met for many people. Else you talk for another minute or two out in the breathe during the prayer. Are there any more joys this morning?
For all the seniors. Graduating.
For the graduates.
Yes.
Go Bullies.
What was that called?
I said go Bullies. It's the Milbury team.
How did I miss that?
Milbury has a team that's called the Woolies.
The Woolies?
The Woolies.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. So for seniors graduating, no matter the names of their teams. All right. So this morning, as we've been doing the last few weeks, I will be kind of grouping of intercessions and prayers of joy, and then invite the congregation to respond. Come, Holy Spirit, come. God, we rejoice and give you thanks this day for the blessings that surround us, for all that brings us joy. We rejoice with the Queen on her 70th Jubilee. A good reason, I guess, to tap our shoes and maybe have another procession. We rejoice and thank you for a new beginning. We rejoice with our youth who are celebrating that school will end next week. And hallelujah, they say. For all of this, O God, we pray, come, Holy Spirit, come. We pray this day for safe travels for Desiree, that her time away would be one of replenishment, that would bring her comfort and bring her joy. We pray for members of our congregation who will be traveling this summer, that you will help them to still feel close to all of us who are gathered here as we pray too for traveling mercies for them. Come, Holy Spirit, come. We pray, O God, for an end to this unimaginable cycle of violence. We pray that you would give wisdom and discernment to Congress around how to best protect our people and our country, how to keep all safe, how to know that there are so many diverse perspectives, and yet the safety of our children is most important to all. We pray for those who continue to grieve for the families in Uvalde, for those in Tulsa, who grieve for members of their medical team. We pray for the people of Ukraine as they still experience this heartache of war, and especially remembering the children, that you too would keep them safe. We lift our prayer to you, O God. Come, Holy Spirit, come. We pray this morning for all those who are struggling with the increase in inflation, the challenge to meet the most basic needs. Give us creative solutions. Help us as a congregation to continue to do what we already do, to care for those in need, for the hungry, for those in need of friendship. We lift, O God, our prayers to you. Come, Holy Spirit, come. On this Pentecost day, we pray the outpouring of your wisdom and guidance and discernment upon this community of faith in a search for a new pastor. Give the search committee patience. Give them stamina. Give them counsel and wisdom that comes from you. We pray, come, Holy Spirit, come. All of our prayers are lifted in the name of Jesus, our Redeemer and our Savior, who has taught us to pray together. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, and thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
Thank you. God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of
with thanksgiving. We remember how Jesus took bread, blessed it, and broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "This is my body given for you." With thanksgiving, we remember how Jesus took the cup, saying, "This is the new covenant in my blood. Do this, remembering me." When Jesus ascended into heaven, you sent your Holy Spirit to teach us, guide us, and abide in us forever. Remembering your mighty acts of mercy, we celebrate this feast with the risen Lord, offering our lives in thanksgiving and praise. Great is the mystery of our faith.
Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again.
Gracious God, fill this place and our very lives with your Holy Spirit, like the rush of the mighty wind, like consuming fire. By the power of your Spirit, feed us with the bread of heaven and fill us with the wine of your reign. Fill us with dreams and visions of that great and glorious day when Christ will come again. Amen. Bread which we break, is it not for us the bread of heaven, the bread of life? The cup which we pour, is it not for us the cup of salvation, the cup in the new covenant of Christ's blood? Beloved, these are the gifts of God for the people of God. Receive your own gifts as you are ready to do so.
Thank you.
form kind of a semicircle in the front here, and Miss Stephanie will be taking some pictures of our church family on this Pentecost Sunday. You all look so festive. It's a great day to do it. Loving in Christ, may God's Spirit be poured out upon you to bring you comfort, to bring you peace, to inspire you on your journeys of faith, to give you trust to move into the future with purpose and with joy. Amen.
Yeah.